craziest SpongeBob pranks ever. SpongeBob has been on the air for over 20 years, and in that time, the series has showcased some pretty incredible pranks. Today, we will be taking a look at some of the craziest SpongeBob pranks ever. But before we get started, remember to hit that like button and ring the notification bell for more videos. Squidward's prank. It's a secret to no one that Squidward hates SpongeBob. The two have been neighbors for as long as they can remember, and are constantly getting in feuds with one another. Aside from this, it seems as though Squidward takes every chance he gets to make SpongeBob and Patrick's lives a bit more difficult. In the episode Fools in April, Squidward decides to play one of the most diabolical pranks ever. As SpongeBob shows up for work at the Krusty Krab, Squidward has set up an incredibly elaborate prank involving wires, hooks, levers, dozens of pounds of flour, and several other humiliating stunts. It seems as though Squidward doesn't understand the true meaning of a prank or April Fool's. All he managed to do was put the sponge's life in danger. There was no real prank here. This is one of the most iconic SpongeBob episodes to have ever been created. It has proven to be a fan favorite for many years and, as expected, spurred many SpongeBob quotes and memes, much like dozens of other episodes from the series. The episode begins simply enough, in a lighthearted manner, as do most other SpongeBob episodes. Though Squidward decides to play his infamous prank on SpongeBob after being fed up with SpongeBob and Patrick's countless pranks throughout the morning. Squidward is very proud of himself after the prank is completed successfully, though SpongeBob begins to cry and runs home. It's important to mention that most times, SpongeBob cries for a comedic effect, though this is one of the few times in the series when SpongeBob is genuinely upset, leading Squidward to eventually give in and attempt to apologize to the little guy. What follows is one of the most emotional moments the series has ever offered. As expected, the two work everything out, and it seems as though their friendship is stronger because of it. SpongeBob's hidden musical talent. It's difficult to decide whether this was a prank or a surprise, though we tend to believe that it was likely both. By all means, Band Geeks is likely the most iconic SpongeBob episode of all time. This episode shows Squidward getting a call from his nemesis, Squilliam. Squilliam's band was scheduled to play at the Bubble Bowl, though they were unable to make it. As it turns out, he wants Squidward to take his place and have his band play that evening. Though, there is one catch. Squidward doesn't have a band. He is forced to find random and untalented members of Bikini Bottom to form a makeshift orchestra, though many of the town folks don't even know what a musical instrument is. With Patrick doing his best to classify mayonnaise as an instrument, Squidward reaches wit's end and calls it quits on the band. Though SpongeBob sets up and convinces the remaining members of the band to press on and do their best to learn a song that Squidward would be proud of. It seems as though, all this time, SpongeBob had been hiding his true musical ability from Squidward. Over the years, SpongeBob has made a mockery of Squidward's talent as a clarinet player, though SpongeBob has never expressed any musical talent of his own. In a dramatic change of events, SpongeBob takes a few dozen untalented residents of Bikini Bottom and turns them into one of the greatest orchestras the ocean has ever seen. This was an extremely daunting and risky task for SpongeBob and his bandmates, but as fate would have it, they pulled it off and put on one of the greatest shows in Bubble Bowl history. Squidward could not be more proud of his friends and bandmates, even though he did very little in regards to teaching them to perform. It would be difficult to classify this event as a prank per se, though we have to wonder if SpongeBob had been keeping this trick up his sleeve for years in hopes of pranking Squidward and proving that true musical talent comes from hard work and determination. The Invisible Sponge. This is a SpongeBob episode that is often overlooked by many fans, though it was one of the greatest episodes from Season 3. This episode begins with SpongeBob pranking Patrick with a jar of peanut brittle. Food is one of Patrick's favorite things in life, so he easily falls for the trick, only to realize that there is no peanut brittle inside the can. SpongeBob explains the prank to Patrick and tells him how he bought the can at a local prank store known as the Palace of Pranks. The two go on an adventure to the store, with Patrick once again falling for the peanut brittle prank. They search the store high and low, searching for the ultimate prank to pull on the entire city of Bikini Bottom. As they are completely out of ideas, the two begin to get bummed out by not finding anything worthwhile in the shop, though the shop owner soon reveals a can of invisibility spray and offers it to the pair for just $1. He warns them that the spray can stain clothes, paving the way for some gut-busting comedy later in the episode. SpongeBob and Patrick decide to spray their entire bodies with the solution, coming up with the idea to pretend to be ghosts and scare every person in town. However, they soon remember that the spray can stain clothes. To remedy this, they decide to strip down completely nude and spray their entire bodies with the liquid, though not before a tour bus full of people drives by while the two are standing nude outdoors. Once they are covered with the spray, they dress up as ghosts and begin their pranking spree. It doesn't take long before seemingly every home in Bikini Bottom has been thoroughly spooked. The two are incredibly satisfied with what they have done, though they soon realize that they missed out on one of Bikini Bottom's most prominent members of society, Mr. Krabs. SpongeBob's boss is notoriously unafraid of ghosts, though SpongeBob and Patrick manage to give Mr. Krabs quite the scare, forcing him to reconsider his confidence and his fear. Mr. Krabs becomes so overwhelmed with fear that he puts on his anti-ghost outfit. This outfit consists of a hat with flame-lit lanterns hanging from each side. He also wears a barrel wrapped in chains and carries a paddle ball as a weapon, though this is where SpongeBob and Patrick make a mistake. The two understand that Mr. Krabs loves money more than anything else in life. To scare him, they decide to burn a $1 bill. The two light a match, but as they are bringing the match closer to the dollar, Mr. Krabs has an idea. He grabs a bucket of water and splashes the match, dousing both SpongeBob and Patrick with water in the process. This causes their invisibility spray to wash off, leaving them both fully nude in the presence of Mr. Krabs. Rather than becoming angry with the two, he sympathizes with them and understands their willingness to prank their neighbors. He offers that he too was a prankster in his younger years. However, he realizes that the two still need to learn a valuable lesson. As SpongeBob and Patrick attempt to lead the Krusty Krab, they realize that the Krusty Krab is now filled with all of their closest friends and neighbors. Mr. Krabs then concocts a prank of his own and welcomes everyone to the live nude prankster show, forcing the two to showcase their naked bums in front of the entire town. The two are more embarrassed than they have ever been, with them trying unsuccessfully to cover themselves from embarrassment. SpongeBob turns to Patrick and mentions that the two should have purchased a whoopee cushion instead. It is episodes like this that have cemented SpongeBob's place as one of the most successful children's shows of all time. Though SpongeBob today is a far cry from what it was when it was created by Steven Hillenburg in the early 1990s. Where it all began. Steven Hillenburg had always been fascinated with ocean and marine life, and these passions helped fuel the many characters he would develop for the series. Steven worked at the Ocean Institute in California for many years, tossing around the idea of returning to college to earn a master's degree in art. Though when Steven attended an animation festival, his plans for the future abruptly changed. He had previously been developing SpongeBob characters for a comic series that he hoped to get picked up, but none of the publishing companies were interested in the story. That's when Steven decided to switch gears and focus more on animation than graphic novels. Steven soon attended a festival with a short cartoon he had made and screened at the California Institute of Arts. Joe Murray, the creator of Rocko's Modern Life, happened to be at the event and was impressed with Steven's work. Joe offered Steven a place on the team at Nickelodeon, with Steven helping to create and direct many of the episodes in the fourth season of Rocko's Modern Life. Steven soon started working alongside Tom Kenny, who would eventually voice SpongeBob in the animated series. When Steven was developing the character, he originally planned to name him SpongeBob, with the show being called SpongeBob Ahoy. Though due to legal issues, the name needed to be changed. Steven settled on SpongeBob, with Tom Kenny later remarking, "Boy, look at that sponge in his square pants," thinking he could get a job at a fast food place. This remark is what led Steven to create SpongeBob's last name, SquarePants. A 7-minute series pilot was soon created, and the rest, as you know, is history. SpongeBob has now been on air for over 2 decades, with new episodes continually being produced. 3 spin-off series are also in development, with the show currently having a catalog of 6 Annie Awards, 8 Golden Reel Awards, 4 Emmys, 17 Kids' Choice Awards, and 2 BAFTA Children's Awards. Needless to say, the creators of SpongeBob have been at the top of their game for many years now and show no signs of letting up.